talking, this tank is salt, this aquarium is salt water. So these are all fish that live in the ocean. But specifically, these are fish that you would find in the Mississippi Sound. We already mentioned the Gulf of Mexico. How many of you have ever been to the beach in Biloxi or Gulfport or Long Beach? Stood on that sand and looked at all that water? Guess what you were looking at? You were not looking at the Gulf of Mexico. You were looking at the Mississippi Sound. And these are some of the fish that would live in the Mississippi Sound. So let's see, in his bucket, to answer your question from earlier, he's got little teeny tiny shrimp called krill. He's also got some anchovies. He's got some bigger shrimp, the same kind that we eat, white shrimp. The little teeny tiny shrimp. And then the bigger shrimp are regular shrimp, white shrimp, just like we eat. And then there's also some larger fish in there called capelin. And then the last thing is he has some cut up squid. We have squid as well. So we feed a variety of things. Some days we'll feed them live golden shiners. Some days they eat worms. Sometimes we'll throw flakes in there for some of the smaller fish. So we try to feed them lots of different kinds of things. So some of the fish that he's feeding, somebody already mentioned the ones with the stripes, the black and white stripes that go up and down. Those are called sheep's head. Now, most saltwater fish have very sharp, pointy, cone-shaped teeth. But sheep's head have big, square teeth, kind of almost like a mammal's teeth. And I guess that's how they got their name. Somebody thought the skull looked a little like a sheep's head. Now, there's other ones in there that have the black and white stripes, too, but they're more faded, and they're much larger fish. And if you look carefully, they have whiskers under their chins. Those are black drum. And they really do live up to their name. They make a drumming noise. And the whiskers are just like a catfish's whiskers. They have taste buds, so they can taste their food with their whiskers. Do y'all see the catfish? They're over here by me on the right side of the aquarium. They like to hang out right here in front of the boat. These are called hardhead catfish. I guess somebody thought they were kind of stubborn. There is one catfish that's different, though. He's called a gaff-top sail catfish. And you can see him later. If you want to come up and look and see if you can find him. He's a little fancier looking than the other catfish. He's got frillier fins and bigger whiskers. And there's only one of them. So I call him Waldo. And I always challenge everybody to see if they can find Waldo. Where's Waldo? See if they can find Waldo. And the young man over here, you already mentioned the stingray. The stingray is by Mr. Lowry's knee there. And they swim along the bottom just like that, and they look for things underneath. Their mouth is actually underneath their body, and the eyes are on top. And this one does still have his stinger. It's about halfway down the tail, and it lays flat against the tail. And you'll notice Mr. Lowry doesn't move around a whole lot, just so he doesn't step or sneal on the stingray. We don't pull the stinger out because it just grows right back and we don't want to hurt the fish. We're just careful about where we step. Now, he's trying to feed a fish that's under the boat right now. You might need to come up real close and see if his head's, just his nose is sticking out. There is an eel under the boat. And there's actually two eels under the boat. One is a gray color and he's called a shrimp eel. And the other is a moray eel.
I think I see the second one.
Oh, there's the first one.
Yeah, the moray eel, that's the moray eel's head sticking out.
See, look.
See, come here.
Yeah, you might want to come stand. She can come stand right up here on the wooden ledge.
Oh, you don't want to see.
There he is.
There he is.
A little bit more of him.
Oh, get it. Come on.
Eels are actually very shy. They have a horrible reputation.
Oh, that fish.
That snapper took his fish. That's a snapper. That's called a gray snapper.
Here, Mom. Let me try another one.
You should try feeding him again. One of the other fish in here I haven't talked about yet is another really big fish. The big golden colored ones with the black spots on their tails. Those are called redfish. If you've ever had blackened redfish, that's what you're eating. And they're in the drum family as well. We already mentioned the black drum. Well, these guys are called red drum.
He's trying to get that eel.
He's still trying to feed the eel, yep.
I don't see an eel. Okay.
You might have to stand up to see him.
Now
just
I see.
Peek over in the hole in the boat there.
What kind of eel is it? Is it a moray?
A moray eel, that's right.
I knew if it was a moray eels like to be in holes.
They do, that's right. They hide. They're very shy. They hide in cracks and crevices, the bottom of the ocean.
Oh, I see.
Most divers know not to ever stick their hands in any kind of hole, a hole in a coral head or something, because that's where eels like to live.
Who's going to get the big fish right there?